And welcome, you're watching NewsX. I'm Rishabh Gulati. Our top story at the top of 5 o'clock, a pen camera device has been found in the newly appointed ACB chief M.K. Meena's office. That's right, it was discovered quite by accident as the chief was wondering why a pen stand on his table had so many pens in it. When he emptied it, he found a microphone inside. Now, we don't know whether this device was planted with the intention of spying or was it simply left behind by a previous official. But indeed, it's extremely suspicious. The Delhi police is currently investigating the case after a notification was also sent to the LG's office. Now, the implications of such a discovery are huge. If it was planted, obvious questions are, who did it and why?
ACB chief in the national capital, M.K. Meena, was mired with controversy. A new snooping scandal has sparked a fresh row. M.K. Meena has said that he found a 4GB pen cam snooping device in his pen stand recently, which was kept there to snoop on him. While several questions are being raised as to who planted that device and who was behind the snooping scandal, of course, there is suspicion being raised on whether the Aam Aadmi Party government was involved in this or not. However, now a probe will be ordered and there will be further investigations to know as to who was behind this particular case. With video journalist Sanjay Rohila, Iknoor Kaur for NewsX, New Delhi.
It's absolutely astonishing to learn that a recording device has been found in the ACB chief's office also.
Video journalist Sanjay Rohila, Iknoor Kaur for NewsX, New Delhi.
It's absolutely astonishing to learn that a recording device has been found in the ACB chief's office also. The ones who are supposed to crack down on corruption are probably working amongst themselves. And we had also learned in the recent past that 36 crore worth rupees was probably being expended by the Aam Aadmi Party government in the Delhi to procure high-end snooping instruments. Was this snooping instrument that was found in the ACB chief office one of such kind? This, I believe, Delhi government should answer.
अब पता नहीं ये गृह मंत्रालय ने फिट किया है या दिल्ली सरकार ने, इसकी जांच होनी चाहिए, क्योंकि दिल्ली सरकार भी बगिंग कर रही है अधिकारियों के खिलाफ और मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर के अधिकारी भी बगिंग कर रहे हैं दिल्ली सरकार के खिलाफ।
मोदी जी के एलजी राज में और उनके डंडे के राज में आए दिन सिर्फ और सिर्फ इस बात की कवायद और कोशिश हो रही है कि वो भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ हमारी लड़ाई को कैसे कमजोर कर दे। अभी आज जिस मुकेश मीणा को जबरदस्ती मोदी सरकार के इशारे पे एलजी ने एसीबी का चीफ बनाया, वो खुद अपने ही विभाग के खिलाफ बयान दे रहा है। और ये मुकेश मीणा वही व्यक्ति है जिसने अभी कुछ दिन पहले गजेंद्र सिंह के मामले में हम लोगों को फंसाने की कोशिश की थी।
Breaking reactions coming in on this story. The BJP has now indicted the Aam Aadmi Party government, saying it's raising serious questions. A direct allegation coming from GBL Narasimha Rao. Listen in.
I think if the media reports about a bug having been found in ACB, in ACP office are true, it raises serious questions. I think from the very beginning we have seen the unconventional ways of Aam Aadmi Party and its government. If somebody in the government was attempting to even bug the office of Anti-Corruption Bureau chief, I think it raises serious questions.
इसका मतलब तो पहले हम ये निकालते हैं कि इस सरकार में ऐसे कौन लोग हैं जो एसीबी के मुखिया के टेबल को जाकर चेक कर रहे हैं। सबसे पहला गंभीर विषय तो ये है। दूसरा, एसीबी मीणा साहब का रिकॉर्ड, जो ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड है, अपने आप में शानदार रहा है। उन्होंने जितने अभी तक काम किए हैं अपने आप में, किसी ने उस पर डाउट नहीं खड़ा किया है। ये पहली बार ऐसा हो रहा है। मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि चूंकि एसीबी साहब ने, मीणा साहब ने इनका जो किसान को इन्होंने पेड़ पे चढ़ाया था, जो जंतर मंतर पे किसान का आत्महत्या वाला कांड हुआ था, उसकी जांच की है। दूसरा, बहुत ईमानदार है, वो किसी से दबके नहीं काम करते, इसलिए ये अपना कोई पेट आदमी बैठाना चाहते हैं, कोई ऐसा आदमी बैठाना चाहते हैं जो इनके इशारों पे नाचे, ऐसा कोई आदमी एसीबी में चाहते हैं। इनको पता है कि मीणा साहब इनके कंट्रोल में नहीं आएंगे, इसलिए उनको बदनाम करने की साजिश कर रहे हैं।
केजरीवाल साहब जरा इस बात का भी जवाब दे दें कि आपका जो डिपार्टमेंट है जिसने आरटीआई को 7 नाम दिए हैं या 7 नंबर दिया है, 7 नंबर्स, एक तो उसकी बता दें कि वो गलत वो है या केजरीवाल साहब हैं, एक जवाब तो ये दे दें। दूसरा, केजरीवाल साहब को मैं पूछना चाहता हूं, दिल्ली की जनता जानना चाहती है और भारतीय जनता पार्टी होने के नाते, विपक्ष होने के नाते हम भी जानना चाहते हैं कि केजरीवाल साहब ये 35 लोग किस काडर के हैं, ये कौन से ऑफिसर हैं, किस पद पर हैं, इनके ऊपर आरोप क्या है और ये ऑफिसर कहां कहां काम कर रहे हैं अभी या कहां काम कर रहे थे, इनका काडर क्या है, हमने बार बार पूछा है, तो उसको सार्वजनिक करें।
ऑलराइट, लेट्स ओपन दिस अप। 4GB पेन ऑडियो वीडियो रिकॉर्डर इन फिट इन टू अ फाउंटेन पेन फाउंड इन द ACB चीफ ऑफिस। इज द ज्वाइंट कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस। He was sitting in the office of an ex-DCP level officer. Nikunj Garg, our internal affairs editor, is joining us live on this broadcast. Nikunj, we've been tracking this story all day. What's the latest?
Well, Rishabh, the latest is that the Delhi police is still deliberating on the issue that whether they need to file an FIR in this case or not. And that would be borne by the fact what the CFSL tells them. The device, I am told, has been sent to the Central Forensic Science Laboratory for the further verification and to see if there is any data in that device. And if the CFSL does indeed give a report which says that, you know, the device is indeed capable of recording or emitting any data, then surely Delhi police will have to register an FIR and ensure that a probe is done as to find out as to why was this bug planted and who planted it.
Okay, and who planted it? But an investigation is underway. But Nikunj, you know, we know that there is a sense of distrust between the Delhi police and the Delhi government of the Aam Aadmi Party right now. One can easily presume this without taking much of a leap of the imagination that any result of the investigation that comes out from Delhi police, if it points to the Aam Aadmi Party, the government will just dismiss it. Is there any move to outsource this investigation to someone else?
Well, I don't think, remember, Rishabh, Mr. Meena is a joint commissioner of Delhi police. He's on the payrolls of the Delhi police. He's also the joint commissioner of the New Delhi Range, other than being the anti-corruption bureau chief. So I don't think they're going to outsource the investigation. Okay. That's not my sense.
Okay, just stay with me, Nikunj Garg. Madhav Nalapat, the editorial director of the Sunday Guardian, with me. I've also got a BJP spokesperson with me to add a perspective. Mr. Rao, if you can hear my voice, an investigation is underway. We don't even know yet who planted this device. Would it be too easy to presume and very politically expedient to accuse the Aam Aadmi Party?
See, the issue is at a very nascent stage right now, and the investigations need to go further before we can get into any assumption at this point of time. But having said that, the prima facie looks as if there is a tactic involved, the regular tactics of Aam Aadmi Party. So we certainly wait and watch by the time the investigations come out with a concrete outcome.
Okay, wait and watch. But like I'm going to take a question that I took with Nikunj, sir. There is a distrust, sir, right or wrong, prudent or imprudent, a distrust between the Delhi police as well as the Delhi government of the Aam Aadmi Party. Would you suggest what kind of an investigation would you suggest, sir, whose results would be incumbent on the Delhi government to appreciate as completely fair? Mr. Rao. Okay, I'll get back to you, sir. I'm guessing you're having an audio connection problem. Can you hear me, sir?
I got you.
Go ahead, sir. Take that.
No, of course, it's very unfortunate that an elected government, which has such a big mandate like Aam Aadmi Party, has developed, the disrespect and the distrust. There is so much of trust deficit between the government and the enforcement agency like the police, Delhi police. It's very unfortunate, and it is unbecoming and complete, total out of the sink kind of politics that, if you don't believe your own agencies, your own country's agencies, what are they going to do? Are they going to import some agencies from outside the country so that they can trust them? If you don't trust Indian agencies, what are they going to trust? Is a big
question. All right, fair point.
And Aam Aadmi Party has to wake up to the fact that they are an elected government, and they are not somebody who's leading mortars and strikes on the ground. Today they have to act responsibly and act within the framework of the constitution into which they are elected as a constitutional body.
Okay, fair point. Krishna Sagar Rao, thanks very much for joining us for now. Professor Madhav Nalapath is also with me on this broadcast. Professor Madhav Nalapath, what do you make of this? Because the man that the Aam Aadmi Party did not want in office finds a bug in his room. We don't know. We don't know where this bug came from. Is it just too easy to blame the Aam Aadmi Party?
Well, the bug could have come from anywhere. It could have been planted there by someone else. It could have been planted by himself. It could have been forgotten by someone who was occupying that room. So it's too early to say, especially in the context of the fact that these bugs are now a rupee a dozen. You can pick them up anywhere. You can pick them up at airports. You can pick them up at markets. And in foreign countries, you can pick up models which can record for hours and hours uninterruptedly. So this is not a very very complicated device. It's a very simple device. But if it has been placed there with the intent of monitoring the speech of this particular gentleman, then someone would have done it, and it will be easy to record who has come into that room over the past hours before this gentleman himself entered the room. So an investigation ought to be very easy.
Okay.
The point is that it is now a war between the Delhi police and the Aam Aadmi Party.
Correct.
And what is happening now, because of this war, a situation is being created in which the Aam Aadmi Party is now being driven to a stage when it will again go back to the politics of the street. So if this kind of thing, non-cooperation, hostility, center versus the Delhi state government, police versus Kejriwal, if this continues, my fear is that the Aam Aadmi Party is going to say, we can do nothing in the secretariat, we are important in the secretariat, because all powers have been taken by central government.
Okay.
We will go back to
all
the
right.
street.
Appreciate your thoughts, Sir Professor Madhav Nalapath. Slipping into a short break on this edition of the broadcast. I'm back in about 2.5 minutes. Don't go anywhere.
Taken by central government.
Okay.
We will go back to
all
the
right.
street.
Appreciate your thoughts, Sir Professor Madhav Nalapath. Slipping into a short break on this edition of the broadcast. I'm back.